Welcome to the part 2 of the temperature controller with PLC project. If you have seen the first part of this tutorial, you can check this out, link is in the upper right corner, and also given in the description box. In this first part we have learnt how to turn on and off the electrical heater using a SSR relay, and how we can turn on SSR with a control signal from the PLC. In the second part, we will learn how we can connect a temperature transmitter with the PLC, and how we can use this sensor to make a basic temperature controller. Before starting, I would request you guys to please subscribe both of my channels, and press the bell icon to stay connected for more upcoming videos. We will install a temperature transmitter in this water container, to monitor the temperature of the water inside this container. A temperature transmitter uses a temperature sensor, usually RTD, or thermocouple, to sense the temperature. Then transmitter converts this small electrical signal from the temperature sensor into a more readable signal, like 4 to 20 milliampere signal. This 4 to 20 milliampere signal is then goes to the PLC analog input via two wires. To read the 4 to 20 milliampere signal from this temperature transmitter, we have installed an analog input module with a Wecon PLC. This analog input module have 4 input channels. We will connect this temperature transmitter at the channel 1, on this module. Before going further into this tutorial, let's see a message from the sponsor of this video. Do visit the Wecon Technologies website. They are manufacturer of most reliable and affordable devices regarding automation industry. Wecon Technologies is the manufacturer and supplier of PLCs, HMI, frequency inverters, and servo motors and servo drives. Wecon Technologies can provide best hardware and software solutions for your next project. If we open the back cover of the temperature transmitter, here we can see the positive and negative terminals for the analog output 4 to 20 milliampere signal. We will connect these two terminals with the analog input of the PLC via two wires. We will connect positive signal wire with the V1 positive terminal, and negative signal terminal with the V1 negative terminal. In last we will connect V1 positive terminal, and I1 positive terminals with a small jumper. If you want to learn more about the wiring, you can see the user manual of this analog input module, link is in the description box. We will insert a temperature gauge in the water container, to see the actual temperature of the water. Wiring to read the temperature transmitter signal is completed here. Now we will see how to program the PLC to read this analog signal and scale this signal into real-world temperature readings. First, we will insert a normal open contact M0. Whole process will be started when this bit is closed. Next, we will use 2 command. This command is used to write the buffer registers of the analog input module. We can use this command to configure the analog channels. If we open this command, there you can find 4 parameters. In first parameter we will insert K0. K0 means this command will write the data in the first module. In the next parameter we will insert K1, this means this command will write data into the buffer register 1. Buffer register 1 is used to configure the analog channels. In the next parameter, we will insert H3331, this means that channel 1 is configured as current input, and rest of the 3 channels are disabled. Now we will take another 2 command. This time we will use it to take the average of some samples of analog data from channel 1. If we open this command, there you can find 4 parameters. In first parameter we will insert K0. K0 means this command will write the data in the first module. In the next parameter we will insert K1. This means PLC will take average of the samples from channel 1. In the next parameter we will insert K4, this means we want to take average of 4 samples from the channel 1. In the last parameter, we can insert 1, 2, 3, or 4, depending upon how many channels, we want to apply the same above settings to take the average sample values. We will insert 2. This means we want to take average sample value for the channel 1, and channel 2. Next we will use from command to read the data from the channel 1 analog input. If we open this command, there you can find 4 parameters. In first parameter we will insert K0. K0 means this command will write the data in the first module. In the next parameter we will insert K5. This means we want to read the buffer register number 5. Buffer register 5 is containing the analog data of the channel 1. In the next parameter we will insert D0. This means we will send the data from the buffer register 5 to the data register 0. In the next parameter, we will insert K1. This means that we want to read only the analog channel 1. In the next rung, we will use divide command to divide data in the D0 data register by 5 and store the result in the data register D10. Why we divide the value in the D0 data register by 5? To understand this, let's understand the concept of analog scaling. We have a temperature transmitter with 0 to 200 degrees Celsius range. Against this 0 to 200 range, the temperature transmitter gives an output signal of 4 to 20 milliamperes. This means that, at 0 degrees output signal will be 4 milliamperes, and at 200 degrees output signal will be 20 milliamperes. This analog signal then goes to the PLC, and PLC analog to digital converter converts this signal to digital values from 0 to 1000. This means that at 0 degrees temperature, the converted digital value will be 0, and at 200 degree converted digital value will be 1000. To get the scaled value, we need to calculate the digital value count per degree of the temperature, which is equal to the maximum digital value divided by the maximum sensing range of the temperature sensor. So, we will divide 1000 by 200, and the result is 5. Now, whatever converted digital value, we have to divide it by 5 to get the real temperature value. For example, if the converted digital value is 100, and we divide it by 5, it will give a scaled value of 20 degrees. So this is how we can scale analog values. If you want to study in depth how to make a formula for analog scaling properly, you can check my other video, link is in the upper right corner, and also in the description box. In the next two rungs, we will try to make a logic to maintain the temperature in the water container between 20 degrees to 50 degrees. 20 degree is the low set point for temperature, and 50 degrees is the high set point. Heater will turn on at 20 degrees or less, and heater will turn off at 50 degrees or above. We will use less than equal to operation to make a logic whenever the temperature is equal to 20 or goes below 20. Next, we will use the set instruction to turn on the Y0 PLC output in case if the temperature goes equal or below 20 degrees. In the next rung, we will use greater than equal to operation to make a logic whenever the temperature is equal to 50 or greater than 50, it will turn off Y0 output, which will turn off SSR and the heater. Now the programming is completed here, and we will upload in the PLC and test it. As we turn on the M0 normal open bit, PLC starts reading the analog input channel 1. As you can see that right now, the temperature is 20 degrees, and it turns on the Y0 output of the PLC. The SSR is on, and heater is heating the water inside the water container, temperature starts to rise up in the tank slowly. As soon water temperature reaches 50 degrees, the comparison operation in the last rung turn off the heater. And now water temperature is slowly going down. Let's play this animation faster. As soon as the water temperature reaches 20 degrees, the comparison operation in second last rung again turns on the heater, and water temperature again starts rising. As soon water temperature reaches 50 degrees, the comparison operation in the last rung turn off the heater. And now the water temperature starts to drop. This cycle will continue until the PLC is in the run mode. That's the end of this PLC tutorial, I hope you like it. Before leaving, I would request you guys to please subscribe this channel, and press the bell icon for upcoming videos. Do check out the sponsor of this video, link is in the description box. Till next time, take care and goodbye.